this show is so exciting because this was supposed to be a one-off, one night only with you and Jake. And then they sold so many tickets that it became four nights. And now it's actually having a run on Broadway.
Yeah, we're doing, like, a lot of nights.
Like, yeah.
Like probably more than 70. I'm not quite sure. We're doing 10 weeks, which is kind of crazy.
And the crazy thing is, obviously, because this, you were not planning on this when you first started it, but you ended up having to start doing the show, like, 6 weeks after you had a baby.
Well, I have never had a baby, and when they called to see if I wanted to do the concert, I was like, yeah, that sounds like amazing. That's a total dream come true. They were like, you'll have a 6-week-old child. And I was like, whatever. He's just going to, like, sleep a lot. Like, a lot.
Yeah.
He just sleeps so much, and all they do is eat. And he didn't sleep at all, and he just ate the whole time.
Yeah. So you had to be a sort of a working mom throughout this whole process. And did you manage? Did it work out all right?
There was milk everywhere.
Okay, gotcha.
We, like, started the process, and I was doing okay, and then we got to the day of the show, y'all. That's a reference from Waiting for Guffman. We got to the day of the show, y'all, and I woke up, and my breasts, first of all, I have lived a life with no breasts. And now I have breasts. So they're not very big, as you can tell, but they're bigger than they were. Anyway, so they were really big. They were really big that morning, and I got an infection called mastitis.
I'm familiar with mastitis.
Yes, so I had some clawed ducts. So I was running off stage. Literally, this is a real thing. I ran off stage, and we would put my breasts on pumps in between songs, and I would just stand there until I had to run back on.
Oh, my goodness.
Yeah, that happened.
I feel like you could have had an equal amount of seats backstage and you would have sold that out, too.
Absolutely.
Yeah, and maybe to, like, some real weirdos, but you still would have sold the ticket.
Whatever.
Tickets are tickets.
Right.
You obviously have a musical theater part of your background your whole life. I heard that you sang, you used your singing, your musical theater background during labor.
I did. At first, I didn't think that would be the case. I forgot to take Lamaze. We just, like, forgot about that part. And I was listening. I don't often listen to musical theater, but I felt like Dreamgirls was the choice.
Yeah.
While I was in labor.
Uh-huh.
So I was bouncing on a ball going, I'm chilling, I'm chilling. I mean, I was going for it. The nurses were frightened. My nurse, Nancy, was really confused and frightened. Anyways, and then when I was actually in labor, I didn't know what to do, so I just was going, and the doctor was very confused, and I just was, like, doing some vocal checks. It was great, though. Got me through it.
And it got your, the baby got out, so it worked.
Barely, but he got out. Yeah.